Hey, Freak Out Kids. Let's take a look at this example here. We have baby A is 2, baby B is 3, and angle C is 60. Notice we don't have a side angle combination like we did with law of sines. We have a side, we have an angle, and we have a side. This is a side angle side setup. And in this type of problem, we use the law of cosines. So we're going to find baby C, and then we'll find A and B. And there's an order that you should do those, and I'll explain it when we get there. First of all, let's find baby C. Our C equation will be C squared is equal to the A squared, the B squared, minus 2 times those individually, times the cosine of the angle of whose leg we started with. We started with C, so we have the cosine of the C. Now, this is not really an equation because on this right-hand side, it's just numbers. So your C squared, so your C will be the square root of that mass. So I would type that mass in. So 2 squared plus 3 squared minus 2 times those by themselves times the cosine of 60. And that is that mass. And then I would take the square root of that. You can either take the square root of the 7, or you could take 7 and raise it to the half power, and that would be the same thing. So your C is 2.64578. And I'm going to keep that answer nice and handy on the screen, because I'm going to use it. I'm just going to import that into my next part. Now, the A and the B, which one would I find first? Since the A opens up to the smaller of the two sides, opens up to the 2, as you know, the B opens up down here to the 3, you should find the smallest angle first. Work your way from small up. So I'm going to work with the A equation. 2 squared is equal to the 3 squared plus the C squared. Instead of typing out that decimal, I'm just going to put down C squared minus 2 times those individually, times the cosine of the angle whose side I started with, and that's going to be the A. Now, in order to get the A by itself, I'll take my 3 squared and subtract it over, my C squared, which I know, subtract it over, my negative 2, my 3, my C, I'll divide those over, under, and then to find the A, I'll take the cosine of the inverse of that side. So, that'll be 2 squared, I'll subtract the 3 squared over, I'll subtract the C squared over, and I'll divide that by the negative 2, the 3, and the C. And the C I know, and that is equal to the cosine of A. And to get the A by itself, I will do the cosine inverse of this mass. And I'm going to type that mass in. Now, I've got the C as the last thing here on my screen. Okay, so parentheses, because I want to group the top. 2 squared minus 3 squared minus that last answer squared, parentheses, close the top, divided by, open the bottom, negative 2 times 3 times that previous answer, close the bottom, and then I'll do the cosine inverse of that answer. And there is my angle A. Now, since cosine is negative in the second quadrant, there's no obtuse answer to worry about with the law of cosines. And then to find angle C, we'll just use subtraction, 180 minus the 60-degree angle minus that previous answer, the A angle, and there is your angle B, 79.1066. Awesome. Let's do another. Baby A is 10, baby C is 5, and angle B is 10. Nice angle or side angle side setup, law of cosines. We need to find baby B first, angle A, and angle C. And because the C opens up to the smaller 5, I'll find the C first before I find the A. So baby B, your B equation. B squared is equal to the other 2, minus 2 times those individually, times the cosine of the angle whose leg started this equation. B started, cosine of 10. On the right-hand side, nothing but numbers. B squared, So that means B would be the square root of all of that. I'm going to type all of that in. 5 squared plus 10 squared minus 2 times 5 times 10 times the cosine of 10. And that would be that mass. I'm going to raise that to the half power, or take the square root, and there's your B value. 5.1497. Keep that answer handy. Let's see if we're going to find angle C second. C equation. 5 squared is equal to the other two squared. I'm going to write down a B instead of writing in that 5.1497. Minus 2 times those individually, times the cosine of whose angle started this equation. And it was C, so it'll be the cosine of C. To get C by itself, I'll subtract the 10 squared over, subtract the B squared over. I'll divide the negative 2, the 10, the B. And that would be equal to the cosine of the C. And then to get the C by itself, I will take the cosine inverse of this mass. So I'll type in that mass. Group your top. 5 squared minus 10 squared minus the B squared. Thank goodness that's my last answer, so I'll just import that. Close your parentheses. Divide. Group the bottom. Negative 2 times 10 times the previous answer for B. Group that. Enter. And then I'll take second cosine, cosine inverse of that mass. And there is my C angle. 9.7065. And then to find angle A, do it the old-fashioned way. I'll go 180 minus the 10-degree angle that I started with, minus that last answer, and there is my angle A, 160.2935. And that is law of cosines for the side angle side setup. Yay, free cow.